Good afternoon. Good afternoon. Allow me to introduce myself first. My name is Joy. I'm the manager of reservation department. I'm working this hotel been 4 years. So welcome you guys come to the Davis International Hotels. May I know your name, please?
I'm Chelsea.
Chelsea, right? How about you?
I'm Andrew.
I'm Andrew. Nice to meet you guys. And a fresh graduate from Davis University, right?
Yes.
Alright, I'm also graduate from that university. Yeah, their hospitality class is very good, right?
Yeah.
Where? Come from? A local?
We're in Indonesia.
Yeah, very
good. So you rent a house here, you stay with your local friends?
Yeah.
Oh, that's very great.
Yes.
Okay, so today I'm gonna conduct a training about effective telephone techniques. So you know why you're here today? Since you guys will have the internship in our hotels, you guys will get a lot of chance to answer the telephone call from guests or from other staffs. So since we are a 5-star hotels, we have our own standards. We expect that all of our staffs can achieve the highest standards, can be professional, and to make their work become better. So have a look with your lesson plan first. You guys all got the lesson plan, right?
Yeah.
Okay. So look at lesson plan. I will break down our today's topic into 5 main parts. They are great caller, put a call on hold, take a message, screen call, and transfer the call professionally. So in these 5 parts, we will have some practice. So I will do a demonstration first, and you guys can follow me. Okay. So don't be worried. Take it easy. It's very interesting topic. Okay. So let's start today's training. Effective telephone techniques. Before we get into our main part, I want to hear some ideas from you. What do you think the telephone manner is very important? Why do you think it's important?
Because like when the guests call to make a reservation or something, we need to make a good first impression for them.
Yes, that's very great. How about you, Andrew?
Yeah.
Have any ideas?
Yeah, it's the same. We are the first good impression for guests when they are calling to our program, so it's really great to make them happy and
Yes, both of you have very correct ideas. And then I want to highlight these four tips. So in the telephone manners, you have to remember in the hotel, you are not calling with your friends, you are not have phone with your parents, so you cannot be like too English style, right? You have to be professional, like a professional hotelier. And first of all, you have to greet in the caller. If you can, sometimes you can decide the caller is man or female, depends on their voice, right? But sometimes you know the person's name, so better address them by their names. Like Miss Chelsea and Mr. Andrew, address them by their names. And then second one is your voice should be gentle and loud. You have to confirm the caller can hear your voice clearly and they can get the information from you, correct information from you. And the third one is you have to be polite and be able to speak fluent English. It's also very important for the caller to get the information from you. And then you have to act very fast and accurate. Sometimes the guest will call you for asking some specific information or ask you to transfer the call, so you cannot let them wait for too long. Okay? Now let's move on to our first part. It's greet a caller. So how to greet caller in our Taylor's International Hotels? I divide them into 2 main parts. One is external call, another one is internal call. So these two is have different method when you greeting the caller. And then I will do a demonstration first and show you how to do this. For the external call, we have to say good morning or good afternoon. Thank you for calling Taylor's International Hotel, Reservation Department, Joy speaking. How may I assist you? You have to mention, since you're calling Taylor's International Hotels, you have to mention our hotel's name, and you have to mention which department are you in and your name. And for the internal code, same things. You have to say good morning, good afternoon, or good afternoon. Reservation department, Joy speaking, how may I assist you? All right, you guys got it? All right, so let's have a try. Is that okay? So, Chelsea, where are you coming from? So let's try first. This time I will be the guest. You can stand in front of me. Here. I will become the guest, you will become the staff in reservation department. Okay, okay, greeting.
Good morning. Thank you for calling Taylor's International Hotel Reservation Department. Chelsea speaking. Oh, yes, it's you.
Okay, very good. Thank you very much, Chelsea. Have a seat. Come in, you have a try for internal call. Okay, greeting.
Good morning.
All right, very good. Have a seat, please. There, you guys, well done. You get it very fast. I'm glad for that. Okay. So, I will move on to the next part. Put the phone call, put the call on hold. So, normally, when you put a call on hold, it's like you have to make a reservation for guests. It may take you some time. Then you have to put the call on hold, and later, you have to back the phone and tell guests, like you help them to make the reservation already and inform them to come in time, right? So how do you conduct a call on hold? You have to say, when you want to put down the phone, you want to put the call on hold, you have to say, one moment please sir or madam, allow me hold the line for a while, I will back in a minute. And then after you pick up the call, like you go search the information, you go make a reservation already, and you come back to pick up the call. You can say, thank you for holding Miss Chelsea or Mr. Andrew, because you, I think this time you know the guest name already, right? So you have to address them by their name. Okay, I can now help you to make reservation for which. Okay. So let's have a second round of try. Chelsea, come first. Okay, so I will become guest. So I want to make a reservation in Taylor's Hotel, the Chinese restaurant. Ring ring. Hello. My name is Joy. I want to make a reservation in your hotel's Chinese restaurant in today, I think, 6 p.m.
Okay, one moment. Please, allow me to hold the line for a while. I will be back in a minute.
Okay, and now you come back and pick up the phone.
Thank you for calling, Ms. Joy. I can now help you.
Alright, thank you very much, Chelsea. Very well. Have a seat first. Okay, the next part is about take a message. So normally in what situation we need to take a message? Normally the guest call you and want you to transfer the call, but suddenly the person they want to phone is not available, then you have to pick up the notes and to leave a message, help the guest to pass the message to the person they want to find. Okay, so maybe you look at here is a lot of contents, but I just want to highlight a few points. First of all, you have to inform the guest the person is not available right now, and you have to write down the caller's name correctly, and you have to spell to them for like twice time, double check, and be always remember to repeat their phone number and to repeat the information you want to pass. And then you can send the caller and inform them you will pass the message to the person they want to phone. Okay. So be sure always there's a note and pen beside you, so it will be convenient for you to pick up them and just write down the message very fast. Okay. And then it's for screen call. So what is screen call? Actually, it's very simple things. Just like normally when the phone comes in, their name, the guest name, or the staff name, the which department, and their phone number will show on screen. So for screen call, I expect you guys can be aware of this viewpoint, and you have to listen to the message being recorded on the answer machine or voicemail, and always remember check the caller ID and check in the time or date which a caller message was received, and you have to pre-screen callers to a request line at the radio station or call in talk show before they allow on the air. Come to the next part. It's about how to transfer a call professionally. So in some situation, like the guest call to the reservation department, but actually they want to find maybe a concierge department, or they want to contact with the sales and management department, and this time you have to transfer the call to other department. Even though in this situation you have short communication with guests, but you have to remember you are still in the one part of the hotel's image, so you have to be always be professional even though you just transfer the call. So I will show you guys how to contact transfer a call professionally. Okay, so if you can sit one moment please. Mr. Andrew, allow me transfer your call to F&B department. Okay, you guys got it? Okay, let's have a second round try. Andrew, please come to in front. Have a try. Okay, so I will become the guest. I want to maybe make a I want to confirm my reservation with the Chinese restaurant, the F&B department. So you have to help me transfer the call. Okay. Hi, good morning, Andrew. I want to confirm my reservation with your F&B department. Can you help me transfer the call?
One moment, please, Ms. Joy. Transfer your call to the F&B department.
Okay, very good. You did very well. Have a seat, Andrew. Alright, so I think you guys done very well with today's training. You guys practice a lot and you guys know how to conduct professionally calling, right? And let's summarize our today's topic. And we have a five-part, they greet the caller. As you guys want to practice before, you already know how to greet the caller from external call and internal call. And then we try to put the call on hold. And then we know how to take a message and what is screen call, the important thing of screen call. And then you guys try how to transfer the call professionally. In your practice, I think you guys performance very well, very professionally. The most important thing is you will have to become more confident when you have a communication with the guest. Okay? So do you guys have any questions for today's topic? No? Very clear, right? Yeah, you guys done very well today. But to ensure that you guys really learn something from our today's training, I have some questions for you. Maybe Chelsea come first. Can you give me like one specific method to take a message? Thank you very much, Ms. Chelsea. And how about you, Andrew? The same questions. Give me one method of screen call.
Methods of screen call. We see the caller's name.
Yeah.
Yes.
And ensure the caller's name, right?
Yes.
Okay, never mind. Let's have a short review. So for screen call, here is the method. We record answer machine or voicemail. Like what you mentioned before, you say we have checked the caller ID, right? And then you have to pre-screen the callers to a request line or call in a talk show before they allow on. Thank you. Alright, so basically it's all about this, above all it's about our today's training. And any feedbacks for me? How about today's training? You guys think helpful for you?
Yeah.
Very, very, very good. Very informative.
chance in your future internship. You can have more chance to communicate with guests and practice with them to improve yourself. Okay? If you got any problems, don't be hesitant to ask me or refer to your senior around you. Okay? So next week we will have a training about customer service and conduct same time, same place. I hope I can see you again. So thank you very much. Thank you for coming today.
Thank you,
Miss Chelsea. Thank you. Okay, hope you guys.